lobbying groups and networks should start to do at some stage. In other art branches, this has been done. You can get some information of certain institutions, but it's really hard to find it out in Berlin, especially since we have a huge scene of international authors, either writing in German, living in Berlin, either writing in German or writing in their mother language, and there's whole literary scenes in Berlin of Spanish speakers or English speakers and so on, and they're often not enough interconnected. You don't know what's going on there in general, and they don't know about what's going on here. But this is starting to change. Nächste Folie. So what does Berlin do to support literature? Nächste Folie. Among others, there's roughly 2.5 million for five regularly funded institutions. For the authors, there's a state scholarship for 16 authors a year. They get 2,000 euros a month for 6 months. And especially relevant for us, the state fund for independent projects, which has a total sum of about 60,000, I think. You can apply for up to 10,000 euros each year. That's a fund really mainly dedicated to smaller players, activists, and so on. That works quite well. And I think it should be raised, and that's one of the issues we lobby for. There's, just to name them, certain other project funds on state, federal, or local level: Hauptstadtkulturfonds, Bundeskulturstiftung, Stiftung Deutsche Klassenlotterie, various foundations of companies or public, smaller local funds. There's all kinds of funding sums from 3,000 or 2,000 euros up to 100,000 euros or more for one project. So now we're getting to gleich das nächste auch noch, to the Free Scene Coalition, which was founded in 2012. The new thing about it is that it involves all major art branches: theater, dance, music, visual art, literature. Literature joined about a year late because we basically didn't have any organizational structure previously in literature. So we only started that a couple of years ago. The Free Scene Coalition calls itself an open action platform for common political goals. There's individual members and organizational members. Some of these organizations that you can read there: BBK, LAF, Tanzbüro, INM, they're sort of unions or cooperatives within one art branch. For instance, the BBK is a union for visual artists, and they have, I don't know, 4,000 members or something like that, and have a regular budget and a regular office, and they advise artists, they lobby for art, and so on. Unfortunately, we haven't had that in literature, but we are a couple of people who join in that, are here today. We are trying to build up something. What aims does the coalition have? There's several of them. First is networking and exchange between branches. As you join together, you're always stronger, of course. Lobbying, in political lobbying, towards the media and so on. We are fostering common actions, common PR work, common lobbying, We try to maintain transparent and open structures and try to get as many people and players involved. There's an open plenum which takes place every 6 weeks maybe, where everyone can go and join and ask questions and speak and tell their opinion. And for the regular work, there's a speakers assembly, and that's a group that meets about every other week. So it does have some results. This is the media coverage within 1 year. It's a huge book, Nächstes. So it does show results. Nobody of us as a single art branch would have managed to get that much public attention. These are some of our main claims. First of all, Germany has started minimum wages only a couple of weeks ago, actually. So every employee anywhere has to get paid at least €8.50, and however, that doesn't work for people who are not employed. Artists usually are not employed. Every time we have a funded project, we have to sign a sheet that we pay our employees at least €8.50, but we're not employing anyone. So we really have to the Free Scene Coalition is trying to get through that we have minimum fees for artists as well, for freelance artists, when as long as they're hired within funded projects. We are for more and other scholarships. One new idea is a research scholarship in art, which means you get paid for some time. This money is buying you time, right? To work on art, you get the money without showing an immediate result, but for researching. The process of producing art is not just sitting down and painting something or writing something. It's much more than that. It's much longer. So another one is a general goal is that a greater share of the public budget goes to independent scene. A big issue in Berlin is the use of state-owned buildings. For years and years, they have been sold to whoever is paying the most for it, and now there should be a change to the few remaining public owned buildings should be used for art. One goal is self-administration in arts. There's certain projects that already do that, but not enough of them. The total amount of our claims is €18.6 million. This old fire engine was used in the city tax campaign by the Free Scene Coalition, which takes us to the Free Scene Coalition's activities. There was a huge campaign in the autumn of 2013. There was the idea to tax the hotel fees by 5%, I think. And this money was supposed to go into culture and mainly in the independent scene. Now we got the tax, but we didn't get the money. Within that campaign, we had personal discussions with over 70 members of parliament. I think Daniela also took part in it, and many other people. We really went one by one and talked to them and told them many of them don't have much of an idea of what independent scene means, and still they have to decide on the budget. We set up a brochure called the 10 Items Brochure with detailed suggestions for the state budget. I have many of them outside, so if you're interested in that. But it's, as you will see, it's really done very detailed, so they exactly know what how to change the budget law according to us, how it should be changed. Within that campaign, there was also all kinds of actions, art interventions, press conferences, panel discussions, demonstrations. We made an interactive map of the locations, the venues for the free scene. There was a black screen program. All cultural institutions were willing to declare their solidarity. They changed their code on their websites, so when you tried to access their website, the screen would turn black, and for a few seconds, and then you would get some information on our activities. Achievements. It's a long way to go always, and it doesn't. This kind of work doesn't show immediate results usually, but little by little we got accepted as a negotiating party in the cultural administration. There was a huge media coverage. There was, in the last state budget, there was a couple of new funds, like the co-funding fund, which is a very useful thing, especially for projects like this one, where you apply for larger money from, let's say, the EU, and you have to come up with a certain share of the money yourself. So by doing that, Berlin is drawing additional money to Berlin, so it's it pays off, I think. You probably ask yourself what a revival is.